YouTube, what is going on? Back with my latest video, back with a really cool pickup video for you guys today. So I got two things that came in the mail from online that I'm gonna show you guys, and I got a really cool thing that I picked up from Target that I'm gonna show you guys as well. So without further ado, let's get right into it, see what I got. Here we go. Listen, been in the game for a minute, clocking in because it's time to get down to business. Starting is a habit, on me I'm good at it. Asking around town, I'm known as the Pop Savage. Alright guys, before we get into this video, please smash that like button down below. Let me know you guys are enjoying these videos, and as always, if you're new to this channel, welcome and hit subscribe button down below as well so you update to my most recent content. Hit that bell notification so you're alerted as soon as I post a new video. So like I said, I got two things in the mail from online. The first one I'm going to show you guys actually came from eBay. So this was actually one of my Speculation Saturdays picks that I made, I guess, 2 weeks ago, and I didn't have it in my personal collection, but I did want to have one, so I picked this one up. We got Kawhi Leonard's San Antonio Spurs pop. So this one's really cool. I like Kawhi. You know, he's definitely an oddball, a fun guy, whatever you want to call him. But this is definitely one I still stand behind. I know a lot of people felt differently in the comment section. To each their own. I think this one will end up being proven to be a good purchase. Like I said, Kawhi's going to go down as an all-time great regardless. It doesn't matter that he lost this year. That team definitely, I think we all can agree, most likely have won that series if he was playing. And I think Kawhi is, again, already a two-time champion, finals MVP twice. So I definitely think he's going to be an all-timer, and for, I think I paid $30 for this one. It wasn't expensive at all. I think in the grand scheme of things, that's a really good deal, especially when you compare it to most of the people back there. I know people talk about Kyrie, his value not going up. I don't think people like Kyrie, so that's what it kind of comes down to. But Kawhi is always going to be an all-time great. So I picked this one up, definitely a dope one. I just love these old school Funko Pops that are like the old NBA ones. The new ones obviously are better. They're more stylized. They look more like the person, but I just like the vintage feel for it, and that Kawhi Leonard definitely epitomizes that. So, like I said, I got another pop. This is part of a huge Hot Topic order I did. They're starting to just trickle in little by little. There's more that actually just got shipped out to me recently. I haven't got them yet, but they just shipped out, so hopefully I get them soon. I can show you guys when those come in. But this one I definitely had to get as one of the few that I liked from this line, and I'm actually looking at it now, it's got a little bit of damage, which is unfortunate. But we got Sylvester and Tweety from Space Jam. So this is actually the first Sylvester and Tweety Funko Pop I have. I guess there's only one other Sylvester and Tweety Looney Tunes one, and actually there is a Sylvester Batman one that I do have. So this is my first Tweety pop, but this one's really, really cool. Space Jam is my favorite movie. You guys are new to the channel. The original Space Jam, I have not seen this one yet, and I don't have very high expectations because I'm not a LeBron fan, but this one's really cool. You got Tweety sitting on the basketball and Sylvester's right next to him. I'm kind of surprised they didn't do the grandma. Maybe she'll be a Funko Shop exclusive down the line or something like that, but they seem to be teasing her a lot in the commercials, and they don't have a pop for it yet, so I would really like to see that. But Sylvester and Tweety, very, very cool. This is going to go in with the rest of my Space Jam collection. I think I'm only waiting on one more pop from this line that's coming in the mail, and then I do want to get that Batman and Robin pop as well from Target. I did check my local Target earlier when I looked for this pop that I'm going to show you guys soon, and they did not have it yet, so hopefully they have it soon. I can get that in the collection and show you guys that as well. But like I said, there's a little bit of damage, a little, I don't know if you guys can even see it on the back, there's a little bent on the box, which I don't care about. This is going to go into my glass case with Space Jam stuff, and it's going to be preserved and protected in there, so a little damage is not a bad thing at all. So there you guys go, Sylvester and Tweety from Space Jam, a new legacy from Hot Topic. So, like I said, I got a cool pop right here from Target. Full disclosure, it is not mine. It's actually one of my friends. He hit me up this morning. This is 4th July that I'm recording this, and told me that he showed me the picture of this, and I was just getting up. I started rushing out the house because I want to get one of myself because we live close by, and he told me to call him for the details, so I called him. He didn't answer. I don't know if he knows the story yet, so if you're watching this now, this is a story. Called, didn't answer, so I immediately got dressed, got washed up, and ran out the house and went to my local Target. Come to find out, I went to the wrong Target. So by the time he called me back, he told me it was the other Target, was the complete opposite direction, and I wasn't going there. So I do not have one myself, but I'm borrowing his to show you guys. And I don't think anybody else has done a video for these yet, and I think this is really popular. And the hyped up pops, I decided I was going to show you guys so you guys can get a look at it and decide if you want to get one into your collection, because sometimes the pictures don't really grasp how a pop looks, and seeing it on video is a lot easier to tell if you want to make that purchase or not, because I think this is going to be a hard one to get. I think you'll probably be able to get it online, because I did hear that it's a rumor that it's going to be online only, which is obviously not true because this one's in my hand currently. But also it's going to be a rush to the store. There's a lot of people trying to flip these. They're going for like 150 bucks online, and you definitely want to make sure you your money's being spent right. So here you guys go. This is the Blacklight Venom t-shirt bundle from Target. So like I said, this one has not released yet. Like I said, this is July 4th. I think this is street dated for July 27th. Don't quote me on that. That's what I remember, but I don't believe it is out, because the Target I went to couldn't even find it in their system. They had none in the back, none in the store, none on the shelf. So I don't know how this other Target got them, how they were able to sell them, because I think when he said he checked out, they weren't street dated. He was able to check out. So if you have a local Target you want to check, they might have these and you might be able to purchase it yourself. But we got my boy Eddie Brock right there, Venom. Now, the t-shirt bundles, the way they're doing them now, I really, really like it. It's so much better than the old t-shirt bundles where it was just in a box and you had to open the box up and see what was in there, the contents. Having the pop right there is a definite upgrade, kind of like how they were doing like the Blu-ray things they were doing in the past. They kind of took that same design and did it on the t-shirt bundles now. Now, I did talk to him. He said he doesn't want to open it, which unfortunately I can't show you guys any more than, you know, what I'm showing you right now. I don't blame him. I would not open this either. That Soup Nazi one I got from Seinfeld recently, I did not open that one as well. Funko's doing an amazing job on the packaging. Here's the other side of it so you guys can see. It's got the t-shirt right there and also the Eddie Brock Venom. Now, this one came in a large. I don't know if they had other sizes. The Walmart exclusive t-shirt bundle, the Seinfeld one, I've only seen XLs in it, so I don't know if that's been your experience. If you have seen a different size, drop down in the comment section below. But normally Funko does different sizes. I wonder if they're going to be only larges for these. But very, very cool pop. It is definitely a hyped up line they're doing right now, the Blacklight stuff. I think there's an Alice in Wonderland bunny that's coming that's Blacklight, or maybe it's not Blacklight, but there's a t-shirt bundle for that. And also Marvin the Martian is coming to Target that is coming this month and look really dope in the same kind of design. But this Blacklight Venom, like I said, is very, very expensive at the moment. It's going for like $150. I don't really think that's going to drop so much when this comes out officially, probably down to $100 at the most, or the least, I should say. But very, very cool pop. And I definitely think it's one of the better ones. I still think the Ghost Rider ride, Funko ride, is the best one so far. I like the Thor and a few others, but I think Ghost Rider is the best. But let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, which you guys think is the best Blacklight Funko Pop down below. I'd be really interested to hear what you guys think. But there you guys go. There's a little 360 view of the box right there. Very, very cool. Very dope design Funko's doing. I definitely give them an A+ as far as the decision to switch from the original t-shirt bundle design into this. Is really, really cool. So there you guys go. Those are the pops I have for you today. Just wanted to show you guys that, because I think that's the first, at least that I'm aware of, YouTuber who's done a review of the Venom Blacklight. So I thought I'd show you guys and see if you guys enjoyed that and are going to get it into your collection. So let me know in the comment section below if you're going to get this Venom pop in your collection, if you can find it at your local Target. Let me know your thoughts and opinions on the other pops as well, and just your opinions in general. As always, like, comment, share, subscribe. If you're new, check me out on my second channel at Savage Breaks, where I do Pokemon and sports cards openings. And also check me out on Instagram at ThePopSavage, so you can stay connected there too. Thanks again for watching, guys. I do appreciate your support as always. And until next time, I'll see you later.